Hey devs, welcome to WebStylePress. If you are new here, consider subscribing and hit bell icon. In React, we create small reusable partials or components, preferably single responsibility components. Then we import, export, mount, unmount these components as they are needed in application. If we need a component, we just import it in any other component and use it. That's the whole idea behind using React. In our example, we are creating a utility file and we are defining multiple components in it. Now, utility file has got all the components, including function components and class-based components, and there's one default component as well. We want to use these components selectively in any other component. We will call these components in our main component. What would we do? How would we import, export these components, functions, and classes for other components? We are looking into that in this video. Export functions, classes, or components from single file. So there are different import statements like this one, import component name from, and this one is the file. It can be utility file or any other file. And then this statement, import, and watch these brackets, and there are three components listed inside it. So import these three components from this file. So mind brackets above to import multiple components. So if the components are not the default components, you will have to use these brackets, and then you can call those components inside these brackets. Or if the component is the default component that is being imported, you can use this simple statement right here. So this is our app component, and let's create this file named as blocks. So this is the main file that we will use to create multiple components inside it. One will be the default component, and then other components will be function components, functional or function based components. Import React and the component from React. And this is the class-based component. So common one, let's use this name, or common components, this one, class common components, extends component, and then render. And return. Class-based component named as common components. So this needs an export, but first we will create other functional components. So function common one. So this is just a functional component and it doesn't need render. We will just use return here. Component one. And that's it. And this is common two. So the component two. And this one will be common 3. So this is component 3. One class-based component and three are functional components or function-based components. Common 1, common 2, common 3, and then common components. Common components main. So we want to output these here. And for that, we will need to export all of these components before we can actually use them. So export default common components main. So this is our one default. You can export one component as default component, and then we will export all other components as well, like this. Common 1, common 2, and common 3. So now we have exported all 4 of these components, and we can use these. We can call these in our main app.js file, and we can display this text from this file right here. So first we will import these components like this. First let's import our default component. Import common components main. From blocks, and then we will import rest of the components like this. From blocks. So blocks is this file. Also, we use these brackets for destructuring. We do not use these brackets for importing. We use curly braces. So these are actually curly braces. But React will consider the curly braces as executable code. So these were not displaying here. So I had written these like this. So do not get confused by these brackets. These are actually curly brackets. So we have imported these 4 components here. Now let's use these components. So let's display the output from this component. This is our main component, and here is the value from that component. Class-based component named as common components. And then let's call other components, functional components here as well. Common 1, common 2, and common 3. So this was 2 and this was 3. Component 1, component 2, component 3. So I am removing these lines to avoid any kind of confusion. And the takeaway from this tutorial is this one. You can import components from even a file, and you can use multiple components in a file, but that is not recommended, because the whole idea behind React is to use single responsibility components and use components as small as possible. But for example's sake, as you can see, we have used a class-based component here and then three other functional components here, and then we have exported these components. Functional components, we have exported these like this with curly braces, and then for the main component, we have exported the main component, class-based component, as a default component, and it doesn't need these curly braces as these functional components do. And for import, for our default component will be imported without curly brackets, and then our functional components will need curly braces to import, and then you can use these. Also, if we use multiple components like this, these component will need a wrapper div element to be placed outside of these components. Like, it can be a div based component, or it can be simple brackets like this. It will also work, but there should be wrapper that should enclose these components to work, otherwise it will give error. Also, class based components need render, but function components just need return, and render is not used for functional components or function based components. And if you are passing properties or props among components, then if these are functional components, they will use like props dot, let's say you are passing a property with name, let's say you are passing a name property, and if it is a functional component, you will use it like props.name, and if it is class based component, then you will use this keyword, this dot props.name. So that's it for this video, guys. I hope you like this video. If I missed anything or you have something to add, you can comment down below. Ask questions related to this topic. If you haven't already subscribe to the channel and hit bell icon to receive updates. Join us on social media. Links are in the description below. Stay tuned for more updates. I will see you in the next video.